studying, looking at these things. Who wrote this letter? Who wrote the letter? Are you sure? Maybe you guys' name was Ephesians, but I don't know. Studying the first three chapters, which talk about our position in Christ, how God sees us, how Jesus saved us, and second is our practice, what we do. First is about doctrine. Second is about application. Today we're going to talk about something that's very applicable, easy for us to apply to our lives. So our walk, our behavior, our actions, four kinds of walks. position in Christ, we discuss several things. How we're blessed, how we're new alive, how we're reconciled, how we're equal heirs, and we have power. All of this is because God saved us through his power, through Jesus Christ. Amen? Now, 2 weeks ago, we talked about walking worthy in unity and maturity. So, we'll pick up with verse 17 today. Walk in your new life. What new life? The Bible gives us a very clear understanding, a clear picture. It'll make it easy for us to understand. So, I'm going to jump into that. Let's pray first. Our Father in heaven, we thank you for the opportunity to dig into your word, to preach your word, to talk about your word, to study your word, to think about your word, to continue to meditate on your word. Your word is rich and inspiring. It gives us the truth, and it gives us life. Lord, we thank you for your word. And I pray that today, that you focus on your word. Help us not to let our minds wander, but to focus and understand the value, the importance of this passage. What the Christian life should look like. How we should behave. What should we do? Finished talking about the body of Christ. How Christ is the head and each part of our body fits together. Just like we are all part of the church. Your pinky toe. Part of your body. Talking about how the body because of that, because we are in the body of Christ, he says, this I say and testify in the Lord that you walk not as other Gentiles walk. Notice this word, other. And the church at Ephesus was mostly non-Jewish. Some Jews were there, there were a few Jews who were Christians there, but most of the church was non-Jewish. And Paul says, your law should look like, should not look like the way other Gentiles walk, worldly people. Your walk should be different from theirs. That's the first thing he says in the opening. Notice Paul's going to explain what their worldly walk looks like. I'll explain that. So Paul says, this I say therefore, because we are one family of God, one body of Christ, don't walk like the rest of the world. But pride, your understanding is darkened, you are alienated from the light of God and the ignorance that is in them, because of the blindness of their heart. Being past feeling, they have no feeling. They are past that. They don't feel anything anymore. Their hearts are hard as stone. Their conscience are hardened. They don't feel any tenderness. They don't feel any peace. And it causes them to become assiduous, to work all uncleanness with greediness. So, this isn't talking about sexual impurity. It could be any kind of sin, lust, any kind of sin. Those are all included in lasciviousness. Sexual liberty, meaning doing things, doing improper sexual things. And all of this can be summed up in the thought that they are living for themselves. They live for themselves. But what they want, what they like. There's a big event 15, 20 years ago. But if it feels good, do it. We see car bumper stickers back on the car. If it feels good, do it. you don't have to worry about God. You can just do whatever you want to do, whatever feels good to you. Go ahead and do it. And that's fine. That's what many of the people in the world do. If it feels good, do it. There's no limits, no strictness, no rules. Just go ahead and do it. They don't care. So, Paul lists these characteristics. Pride, they don't care about God. Their hearts are blinded. There's no conviction. There's no sexual. They have sexual sin. They have a filthy lifestyle. That's the world. Even good people in the world. So think about a good person in the world. Someone who is well thought of as a good person. Bill Gates. Right. So think about this. Without Jesus Christ, without a relationship with God, it leads to this. That's the result of living like the world. And it's sad that this is the result. So Paul says, that's not what you learn in Christ. If so be that you have heard him, and have been taught by him as the truth is in Jesus. He says, you know different. And many Christians know. All these things are sins, right? They know what sins are. They know that pride is a sin. You know that, right? You know that not caring about God is a sin. You know what this means. You're hard-hearted. No conviction. You don't feel anything. You don't care. Sexual sin, filthy lifestyle. You understand what all that means. Right? Is that good? How do you know it's not good? How do you know that? Because the Bible taught us that. God's Word teaches us this. So, of course not. We know this is a sin. Obvious. We don't have to wonder and say, well, gee, I don't know. Is it? No, we know it's not. We know it's a sin. It's not right. But Paul says, you know better. You're saved. You've been taught, and you understand, you know better. You know that. There's no excuse for you. Now, verse 22 through 4, I do this. Thank you. that you do what? I know this word, put off, it's great. What does that mean? It has, you know, the example is of clothing. You know, if I take off my jacket now, right? Notice this word, conversation. It does not mean communication. It means your life, your behavior, your lifestyle, who you are, what you were before. Take it off. That's the old man. Corrupt according to the deceitful lusts, and be renewed in the spirit of your mind, and that you put on the new man. Put on what? Is my jacket on or off? It's on. How do you know? You can see it. Oh, okay. Put it on. Putting on the new man, which after God is created in righteousness and true holiness. So when you accept Jesus Christ as your Savior, Paul is writing to the church to encourage the church, your old actions, your old behavior, your old habits, your old ways, your old tendencies, what should you do? Take them off. Put them off. And what? Put on the new. What would be new? Righteousness, holiness. Now, of course, that's common sense, but many people, when they're saved, they say, now that I'm saved, I have to stop smoking, I have to stop drinking, alcohol, I have to stop my sexual sins, all that. So, I'm going to try and practice very hard. I'm going to try hard and I struggle. And I become trapped in this circle of struggle. That's what people do. Hearing and deaf alike. I have to stop being bad. That's not what God calls us to do. He calls us to stop being bad and start being good. Why? Do I need to do both? Why do I need to do both? Because being good, doing good will help me to not be bad. When I put off the old man, I need something to help me do good. I need something new. I need something, a new way, not just to say, I don't want to do things the old way. I want to put off the old and put on the new. So, now, the new man righteousness and true holiness. How do we do this? How do we do this? How do we put off the old and put on the new? How? I wish I had a verse that told me how. Oh, I do. I do. Look at verse 25. Right, we are responsible for changing our behaviors from righteousness and holiness within us. Therefore, because what we just said, taking off the old and putting on the new, and how do we do that? What does this tell us to do? Stop lying. Speak every man truth with his neighbor. For we are members one of another. Be angry and sin not. Let not the sun go down upon your wrath. So I'll talk more about that. Neither give place to the devil. Let him that stole steal no more, but rather let him labor, working with his hands the thing which is good, that he may have to give to him that needeth. Let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth, but that which is good to the use of edifying, that it may minister grace unto the hearers. So, what he says is comparing old with new, good with bad. For every bad thing, there's a good thing. Don't do this, do this instead. Don't lie, instead tell the truth. Don't sin out of anger. Don't let the devil have a place. And instead of stealing, give. Instead of saying bad things, say good things. Encouraging things. Build people up. So you see the comparison. Way of life. That's the old way of life. We need to practice and force ourselves to tell the truth. So, now, these things lead to guidelines to you for your life. And I have people come to me and say, I want to be more like Jesus. Good for you. I want to live for him. What do I need to do? Well, here it is. It's obvious. Lying, sinning in anger, Satan into your life, stealing. Laziness, those wrong words that have no place in our lives. And how many of you make mistakes, right? Everybody makes mistakes. I do too. I'm not perfect. Again and again. Why? He wanted to make us good. He wanted us to get good at it. Now, okay, Mark, what's the point of the free throw? What are you talking about? The point is that we have experience. Stop doing things the old way, the behavior, and practice doing things the new way. If I'm saved and I stop, I have to stop lying now. Oh, I failed again, I lied again. forgive myself. I'll now write him. I have to stop lying and start telling the truth. Oh, I have to have a new behavior. Instead of lying, I have made up my practice telling the truth. Remember one boy when I was a new pastor, he was, his name was Mark, just like mine. And every, why are you telling me this? I don't know. And I'll explain to him his principle. You shouldn't just stop lying. Instead, force yourself to admit the truth. This is a new way. And that's when he got serious and he started to practice. It's like the free throws. And sometimes you're not going to be perfect. You have to, and you miss them sometimes, but you have to do it again. Almost done, okay? Stay with me. Words are important, but all bitterness and wrath, anger, clamor, and evil speaking, be put away from you. With all malice, bad behavior, put that away. And be kind to one another. Forgiving one another, even as God in Christ has given you. I use this often when I counsel. If you feel that you can't forgive someone, Christ forgave you. Yes, Christ forgave me. Well, then why can't you forgive him? Oh, because you don't understand. You don't understand what they did. What have you done against God? Now can you forgive someone? So this word bitterness is like poison and wrath. You know, when you get experienced that before, that's what we're talking about with wrath. Anger and clamor. Yelling out because of anger. And even blasphemy. Be put away from you. Sexual sin, filthy lifestyle, lying, sinning in anger, allowing Satan in, stealing, laziness, wrong words, bitterness, wrath, anger, clamor, evil speaking, and malice. Here's the list. Do you think the Holy Spirit enjoys these things? What do you do? Get rid of them. Get rid of them. Clean up your life. It's very simple to apply this to your life. Clean up your life and do what? Add the new man. So the black words here describe the sin, the blue describe the new behavior. So the pride, get rid of pride and substitute humility. Instead of a blinded heart, get rid of that and substitute an open heart. Instead of sexual sin, get rid of that and substitute purity. Instead of blind, substitute telling the truth. Instead of allowing Satan in, resist Satan. Instead of laziness, hard work. Instead of bitterness, forgiveness. Instead of anger, grace. Instead of evil speaking, good works. Good work, I'm sorry. Instead of not caring about God, have a relationship with God. No conviction, instead, tenderness, filthy lifestyle, substitute Christian living, sinning in anger, substitute love, stealing, wrong words, instead of wrath, substitute patience, instead of clamor, substitute peace, instead of malice, substitute moral goodness. So you have the old man with his problems. Automatic. I can do it every So practice good behavior in your life. It will change you. When you start feeling angry, stop and cool off. Practice this. And practice it on purpose. When you feel that anger coming, stop it. On purpose. I will humble myself. I will put myself down. And I'm sorry for this misunderstanding. I'm sorry that we miscommunicated. And really, I'm sorry for my pride. I'm sorry. Please forgive me. Your behavior, your character. Holy Spirit, which seals our hearts. It enters into our hearts and lives and minds. I pray that my heart and mind and myself would be clean, a clean place for the Holy Spirit to live. Show the world who we are as Christians. We say, prove it. We have the actions. Prove it. And invite others to look at our character, to judge us. We should be willing to be judged by the world. Help us, Father.